Nnamdi Kanu sent a shocking message to IPOB ahead of his trial. Hear what he said. The embattled leader of the indigenous people of Biafra IPOB, Nnamdi Kanu, has called on his supporters to embark on fasting and prayer ahead of his trial. AnadonLine.ng reports that the IPOB leader is set to continue his trial at the Federal High Court, Abuja, on October 21st. The IPOB leader's lawyer, Ifeanyi Ejiofor, who spoke on behalf of Kanu, said no excuses will be tolerated from the Department of State Services not to bring the pro-Biafran activist to court. According to him, Nnamdi Kanu is strong and tenaciously holding firm in spirit ahead of his trial because Justice Binta Nyako. Ejiofor said as the D-Day approaches, the legal team is not leaving any stone unturned towards ensuring that all the T's are crossed and E's dotted. It was indeed an eventful visit as our indefatigable client found as laughable the series of false narratives being spread to the public domain, ostensibly sponsored by the agents of darkness who are very deep in the dream to prevent his appearance in court and to create a state of panic in the minds of his followers. Prominent among the falsehood desperately championed by mischief makers is the trending subject that our dear client Onyedumazi Nnamdi Kanu has been flown to China, and from China to Israel, and from Israel to Cotton Kafaki, etc. We know the purveyors of this fake news, and they are aware that their evil conspiracies are dead on arrival. Onyedu was equally amazed by another fake news that was making headlines in some social media quarters, that he was asked to sign any document before regaining his freedom. This is total falsehood, and he is urging his esteemed followers to please ignore this falsehood. Above all, our indefatigable client is strong and tenaciously holding firm in spirit. He is ready for the 21st October 2021 appearance in court. This date is sacrosanct and shall remain so. Thankfully, the federal government of Nigeria is fully aware of this date, and more compelling is the fact that the detained authority has since over a month ago concluded every purported investigations into the matter. Hence, no plausible excuse will be available to them not to produce Onyedumazi Nnamdi Kanu in court come Thursday, the 21st day of October 2021. You must all see him live and direct on this date. Our client, Onyedumazi Nnamdi Kanu, urges millions of his followers and supporters to continue to conduct themselves and carry on within the ambit of the law, as you all have always done. More strikingly and commendable is the fact that your solidarity has remained unshaken against all intimidating circumstances, and for this, he is deeply grateful. Onyedu advised his supporters and millions of followers to go into dry fasting as the D-Day approaches, because resounding victory will be ours on this date, and the almighty Chukwu Okike Abiama will be given the glory and adoration in the end. Nsogbu. Wow. My prayer too has been that at least by the grace of Almighty God, Nnamdi Kanu is going to get a successful and resounding trial. You see, as the IPOB members are praying for Nnamdi Kanu, so are the people outside there equally praying. You've had the international lawyers, international body organizations and what have you sending messages to the president ahead of Nnamdi Kanu's trial. It's not only IPOB. I just concluded a broadcast that spoke of the international observers sending a message to the president ahead of Nnamdi Kanu's trial, advising him on what to do, pleading for a fair trial for the IPOB leader. The same thing goes to the governor of Rivers, Nelson Wike, also calling Buhari to order, telling him that Nnamdi Kanu should be given a fair prosecution. Buhari should follow what is in the constitution and judge Nnamdi Kanu. You understand? Everybody has been calling him to order. And if I am the president, I will know what these people are actually talking about. You see, reputation is more than anywhere else anybody will ever go for. Because if you don't protect your reputation and you acquire that wealth, I tell you, will go down after your reputation has been destroyed, because you will use that money to win back your reputation, but then you will lose it and will still not gain it back. You understand? So Buhari should fight for his reputation, because it is not just Nigerian that is interested in this case. It is the whole world. Unless he's not interested in his reputation. You understand? Unless he's not interested. It is only a fool that will not be interested in his reputation. You understand? Only a fool. But a wise man will always know that his reputations are important. You understand? And what is making me to believe that President Buhari will not want to follow the instructions of the people is because he knows that his administration has already faltered. His administration is already having an issue. You understand? He's already having an issue. He's already having a problem. There is a serious problem in his administration. So I think the administration is really suffering. And they are very much afraid of what is going to be the outcome of Nnamdi Kanu's trial and damages they will be asked to pay after Nnamdi Kanu win the trial. So the administration is seriously afraid. I'm telling you the truth, seriously afraid. But that is their own cup of tea. That's what they call for. So they then dance to the tune. It's nobody's fault. You understand? It's nobody's fault. It is their fault. This is a fault. So let them bear it. You understand? So, my dear listeners in the house, I tell you that whatever anyone is facing today in this administration should not be like a surprise package to that person, but should be a message to you.